Now that we've established the site series of our study location, we should think back to the whole point of this system in the first place. What are we trying to get out of this information? So there's a number of things we can do related to forest management in particular. So BEC provides a framework for detailed, specific site-level timber, range, and wildlife management prescriptions. This includes tree species selection, forage species on range if it's an area where there's grazing animals, site preparation, residue management, particularly slash burning, seedling stock type, stocking standards, what density and how many seedlings to plant, silvicultural systems, and coarse woody debris assessment and guidelines. With regard to tree species to plant, on this edotopic grid here, I have the red square showing our site series, and each of these grids shows the edaphic amplitude of a specific tree species. So we can see that some species like western red cedar grow well in a wide range of conditions, whereas others like Sitka spruce are a little bit more specialized, have a narrower edaphic amplitude. And we can use this to help us figure out which tree species to plant in an area. And this has actually already been done in detail for each of these site series. We can look at recommended plantings for our site series, and to help us interpret that, we can look at this key and the species abbreviations above. So for our site series, the primary recommendation, or the general recommendation, is western red cedar, amabilis fir, and perhaps western hemlock as a secondary species. And an alternative recommended species composition would be Sitka spruce and Douglas fir. If we're managing for timber, and our goal is to optimize productivity, in addition to thinking about which tree species to plant, we might be interested more generally in the productivity of the site. And for that, we can use site index. Site index is a measurement that is the typical height of a 50-year-old dominant tree of a given species at a given site. So this is site series specific and species specific. And site index is a description of site productivity. It can guide silviculture, and it can also help project yield and timber supply and inventory. This is detailed site index information for western hemlock for the site series of our study area. So in our site series, the site index is 30.5. That means that we would expect, on average after 50 years, the dominant western hemlocks at this site would be 30.5 meters tall. In some of the field guides, this is spelled out with a little bit less detail, and the tables look more like this. So we have a Roman numeral 2 as the site index class for our site series. And if we look that up, we see a box plot of the site index for different species in this class. And the way you can read that box plot is the middle 50% of observations are the top and bottom of the box. That's the interquartile range. So for our site series, for western hemlock, for example, we would expect that the interquartile range in height of 50-year-old trees would be about 23 meters to about 31 meters. If we're managing for timber, we might also be interested in the potential for competing vegetation. That's also in this table. This is the potential of the site to produce vegetation that may impede crop tree establishment and growth, so something that might need to be considered. The letter is a severity code. How severe is the potential of that competing vegetation to impede tree establishment? And the number is a vegetation complex, so what are the main species? In our example, our site has H for high severity, and the vegetation that we would expect is a red alder shrub complex. Lastly, after harvesting, sometimes the slash, the residual biomass, is burned to remove it from the site. If the organic layer of the soil is consumed by that fire from the burning, some of that nitrogen is lost, and this reduces site productivity. For this reason, there's also a key that we can use to figure out the sensitivity of a given site to slash burning. This is a key like the SMR or SNR key, so we can follow it through for our site. First question, is the soil less than 25 centimeters deep and or coarse fragment content greater than 80%? And neither of those are true. Is the slope greater than 80%? No. 50 to 80%? No. 33 to 50%, no. Is there a water table, seepage, models, or periodic flooding? And no, we did not have that. Is the humus form a mull or a motor with an AH horizon? Yes, we had a humus form of a motor with a thin AH horizon. Is the soil particle size coarse? Once again, there's our definition of that. And we had a silty loam with 50% coarse fragments, so that is not coarse by this definition. So that leads to a slash burning sensitivity of very low for our site. Wrapping things up, we went through quite a bit of material. We started by determining the biogeoclimatic unit, by looking at maps and comparing the vegetation that we saw at our site to reference vegetation summary tables for those biogeoclimatic units. We did environmental analysis to identify the soil moisture regime and soil nutrient regime. We did two approaches to vegetation analysis, first analyzing indicator plants, and second comparing our results to reference summary tables. And then we took all of those site series classifications that we had done and integrated them to come up with our final classification. And lastly, we looked at reference material that had already been developed for that site series to get information about how we might manage a forest of that site series.